Welcome back to Maker Mindset. Today, I have for you the second part to my Illustrator tutorial. If you need a refresher on the basics, be sure to check out my part one in the Maker Mindset playlist. Today's tutorial will focus on four tools: the pen tool, direct selection and selection tool, anchor points and handles, and pathfinder and align. And we'll also focus on three functions slash shortcuts, which are group, transform, and duplicate. I want to try something a little different, so I want to teach these tools and functions by demonstrating them in a design. We are going to be tracing Jupiter and transforming the planet into an atom. All right, let's get started. First, I pulled up an image of Jupiter, and I'm just going to grab a color using the eyedropper tool. Next, I'll create a new layer and just begin by tracing a ring with the pen tool. Having selected the pen tool, clicking onto the canvas will create an anchor point. By clicking again, this will connect those two points. And if you click and drag, you can create a curve, which is very useful for creating organic shapes, just like what we're doing now, creating the rings on Jupiter. And we'll continue to click and drag until we finally close our shape by clicking back onto the initial anchor point. Now we have created our first ring. So you can zoom in and use the direct selection tool. You can access this by just hitting A on your keyboard. The direct selection tool cursor will allow you to move individual anchor points, whereas the selection tool will only allow you to move the shape as a whole. The direct selection tool will also allow you to adjust the handles of the curves of the shapes. After tracing the next ring of Jupiter with the pen tool, I'll create this negative space inside of the eye of Jupiter. If the direct selection tool is selected, you can hold Alt or Command and click on these little dots at the end of the handle to adjust the intensity of the curves. Notice that the handles are only visible based on which anchor point is selected, and each anchor point can only influence the lines they're connected. Now, I will use the negative shape I just created to cut a piece out of the shape I previously made behind it, in this case, Jupiter's ring. Go to Window, Pathfinder. Now make sure the negative shape is on a layer above the ring shape, and select both. Shift click on both of them, or click and drag and select both. Finally, click minus front on the Pathfinder window. Notice that whatever shape was in front was negated from the one behind it, and you are left with one shape. Pathfinder is a very useful tool for taking the relationship of two shapes and using that relationship to create a brand new shape. And Pathfinder has several different sub-functions that will all give you different results. And once again, you can use the direct selection tool to make adjustments to your points and curves. One small but very useful function is duplicate. You can duplicate a shape or multiple by selecting them and holding Alt or Command and clicking and dragging from that shape and away from it. I will use duplicate and another sub-function of Pathfinder called intersect together to create the highlighted portion of Jupiter, and I will repurpose the circle that is sitting in the very back as the shadow of Jupiter. As you can see, intersect will give you the shape at which the two layers are intersecting. Notice that you can only use Pathfinder with two shapes selected, because Pathfinder is only based on the relationship of those two shapes. You can even take this a step further and explore some more of the functions of the Pathfinder tool and create even more complex shapes. You could also simply draw them with a pen tool, but the Pathfinder tool allows you to do this with a lot more accuracy. I just don't have enough time in this video to show you all those subfunctions, but they're all very useful. Finally, to demonstrate our last two tools, align and transform, we must perform our last function as well, group. To group, select all of your shapes by shift-clicking them individually and hit Shift-G. Grouping is very useful, especially when working on a large scale. Now, we will transform Jupiter into an atom by duplicating it. Remember, holding Alt or Command and clicking and dragging. So right-click on the duplicate and go to Transform, then Reflect. And you will see that this will allow you to flip your image on the horizontal axis or the vertical axis. Transform is a very versatile and extremely useful tool, and I use it almost all the time. Before we finish, let's duplicate a few more Jupiters to demonstrate the Align tool. Align is located right next to the Pathfinder tool window. Let's spread them out a bit just for demonstration purposes, and we can go ahead and select them all. Now, if you're looking at the Align window, you can start by clicking Horizontal Align Center. Notice all the objects you have selected meet in a column in the center. Now, this works regardless of no matter what kind of shapes you have. And it also works on group shapes. And it's particularly important in this case that our shapes remain grouped so that they continue to be Jupiter. Now, each subfunction of a line gives a slightly different arrangement of shapes, and I'm not going to get into all these little subfunctions, but you're more than welcome to click on each of them and just see what they do. It's very self-explanatory once you actually see what they're doing. A line is also a great tool if you're looking for symmetry and overall consistency in your work. And unlike Pathfinder, you can select as many shapes as you want using the Align tool. So, after everything we've learned, let's combine all of it to finish our Jupiter atom. Please leave a comment if you have a question in the comment section below, and like and subscribe if you want to see more STEM-related tutorials.